Hello everyone, welcome to the topic number 07 in the unit 2 interference. This topic is called as a Lloyd single mirror experiment. In this experiment, we learn how the coherent sources are formed, why central fringe is dark in Lloyd's mirror experiment, and also we can calculate the wavelength of monochromatic source. So these are the primary topics that we are learning from Lloyd single mirror experiment. Consider a monochromatic source. S1 is placed very near to plane mirror MN. This plane mirror MN polished on the front surface and blackened at the back to avoid multiple reflections. Hence the light rays incident and reflect on the front surface only. So, no light ray reflect from back surface. The line passing through the upper surface of the mirror is called principal axis. The line perpendicular to principal axis and very far from mirror is called screen. These two lines are meet at point O. Now, one light ray coming from S1 is incident on at the mirror edge M. with grazing angle. Here, grazing angle, that means grazing incidence, means the incident ray and reflected rays having same intensity. So, the fringes formed on the screen have a good contrast. So, that's why I put in grazing incidence. Okay, so the incident light ray at M reflect and incident on the screen at A. Similarly, another light ray which is coming from S1 directly travels as shown in this animation and reaches the point A in the screen. Similarly, another light ray coming from S1 is incident on the mirror at edge N. So, at N, one light ray reflects and incident on the screen at B. At M, second light ray directly transmits an incident on screen at C. Now, extend the light rays at MA and NB towards to back. Then, these seems to be emerging from virtual source S1 dash. Hence, real light source S1 and virtual light source S1 dash are acts as coherent sources. From due to these coherent sources, on the screen at AB range, we will get interference fringes. Hence, fringes are not appear in the entire screen. Only limited range on the screen AB. So, interference fringes are formed at AB range only. At point O, fringes are not formed because the light rays coming from light source S1 are only meeting at O. But at the point O, the light rays are coming from light source S1 dash are not meeting. Hence, there is no superposition of two light coherent sources at point O. Hence, that's why we cannot get fringes at point O on the screen. For suppose, screen is placed at just contact to the mirror N point, then two light rays are coming from both the light sources S1 and S1 dash are superposed on each other. Hence, central fringe is formed, but this central fringe becomes dark fringe because due to this mirror MN, the light ray reflected from rarer medium to rarer medium on the mirror surface. Hence, there is a phase change pi on reflection. So, this is a very important topic. This topic we discussed on the last class. If you have any doubt on this, please look onto that video. Hence, due to the reflection from rarer medium to rarer medium on the mirror surface, an extra 5 phase change is formed between S1 and S1 dash light rays. That is lambda by 2 path difference between the two S1 and S1 dash light rays. Due to the path difference lambda by 2 at N on the screen, the central fringe becomes dark fringe. Here we can measure the wavelength of monochromatic source by using this formula, lambda is equal to beta into 2d by capital D. So this formula is also used in Fresnel's biprism also. The same formula is used in here also. Here 2d represents the distance between the S1 and S1 dash. That means the distance between the real source and virtual source. The distance between the principal axis and the light source becomes d. So we can calculate 2d value from the above statement. Similarly, the distance between the source and screen, capital D, which is also calculated from the scale. Here beta is the fringe width, can be calculated by using microscope. Hence the wavelength can be calculated from this formula, that is called lambda is equal to beta into 2d by capital D. Now we will look into the difference between the Fresnel's biprism and Lloyd's mirror. In Fresnel's biprism, both sides central fringes are formed. That means when you take central fringe on the downside and upside, on the entire region we will get interference fringes up to certain range. But in Lloyd's mirror, only one side of the central fringe, that means fringes are formed. Moreover, in Fresnel's biprism, the central fringe becomes bright, whereas in Lloyd's mirror, the central fringe becomes dark. And moreover, in Fresnel's biprism, two virtual sources are formed, whereas in Lloyd's mirror, only one virtual source is formed. This is a difference between the Fresnel's biprism and Lloyd's mirror. So these are the major differences between the Fresnel's biprism and Lloyd's mirror. So this is our topic. So please subscribe our Telugu Gamanam channel for more lecture videos. Click the bell icon for notifications. If you want to get lecture notes for this lecture video, click the description link below in the lecture video. Thank you for watching this video. See you again in the next lecture video. Have a nice day. Thank you one and all.